This is video presentation number 22 for the Case Plant course. As you view this video, make notes of important information. Pause, repeat, and resume the video whenever necessary. Macronutrients, Lesson 6.1, Plant Food. You have completed Unit 5 Taxonomy. Now, we shift our focus to explore plant needs. The next lesson we will complete addresses plant nutrient needs. This presentation is an overview of the primary and secondary macronutrients. The 16 nutrients required for plant growth and development are categorized by need. Each category and nutrient will be discussed in more depth. The three essential elements, carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, are present in the soil and air in the forms of carbon dioxide and water. All three nutrients make up glucose molecules manufactured by plants during photosynthesis. Some greenhouses are serviced with generators to increase carbon dioxide levels by up to 2 to 4 times. This increase in carbon dioxide concentration accelerates plant growth since plants use carbon dioxide. Fertilizers are balanced for macronutrients. In special situations, a fertilizer may have a micronutrient added. Micronutrients will be discussed later in this lesson. Primary nutrients are required in the largest amounts. Nutrients are represented by their elemental symbol as shown here for nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. N, P, and K are the first three numbers for any fertilizer formulation. If an element of N, P, or K is not present in a fertilizer, the fertilizer bag will use a zero for this element, such as 16-0-8. Secondary micronutrients and macronutrients are not represented by zero numbers if they are not present in a fertilizer. Nitrogen, or N, gives green plants their bright green color. It is one of the most used of all nutrients. Nitrogen influences the development of proteins and is essential for cell division, photosynthesis, vitamins, use of carbohydrates, and the energy reactions in plants. Phosphorus, or P, influences root health and growing seedlings. If ample phosphorus is available to young plants, they will develop strong root systems that are important for their survival. Later in the life of the plant, phosphorus will again play a major role in reproductive health. Potassium, or K, increases photosynthesis, water use efficiency, and disease resistance. Secondary macronutrients are needed in slightly lower amounts and typically affect how a plant utilizes other nutrients. For example, calcium has a relationship with nitrogen metabolism. Magnesium affects both phosphorus and iron utilization. Plants rely on sulfur to develop enzymes and vitamins within the plant. Plants that grow in an environment lacking one of the secondary nutrients, as shown here, are usually unthrifty or less productive. As a review, mark or highlight three key points in your notes that are important to remember from this presentation. List two ideas or concepts that relate to previous knowledge. List any questions you have about this topic. Discuss these questions with your instructor. Keep any notes you have from this presentation organized and available for use throughout the course. Through Activity 6.1.1, In Search of N, P, and K, you will perform soil tests to detect the levels of nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium in order to understand that plants obtain required nutrients from the soil. Your teacher will provide instructions for the soil testing lab activity.